grant you newness of life in Jesus Christ. Amen. Thanks be to God. And you may be seated as we take some time to honor our graduates.
Others, and in the
Bless them and keep them. Guide their steps. Hold them forever in your grace, and by your Holy Spirit be present in their journey, that they may go with the one that is the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you, each and every one of you. Amen.
Taught me how to be the best mother I can be to my children by being the best mother to me. Loving Mom. On May 24th, 2014, I received another mother as I married into the Wager family. As many of you know, Tammy is known for making yummy sweets and meals. As for me, I set our smoke alarm off just last week as I was cooking my family's supper. I try my best to make my meals just like hers because I know how much Justin loves her cooking. She's so patient when she tries teaching when she's teaching me how to prepare a new meal or bake a sweet treat. She has such a big heart, and I love her for that. As long as I can remember, I knew I always wanted to be a mother. Driving to and from college, I had a lot of time to think about my life. As I drove, I remember thinking how far off having children would be. Justin and I weren't engaged yet, and then it takes time to plan a wedding. I still have a few years left in college, no job, and then it takes 9 months for the baby to grow. It seemed like an eternity. And then suddenly I blinked, and our sweet Emily Jo arrived to me early on March 12, 2016. I remember waking up that morning, feeling some light cramps. Still being 10 weeks out, I didn't really think anything of it until I could start timing them. I called my parents at 7 a.m., and my dad answered. He said, "Hey, what are you doing up so early?" And I said, "Well, I think I would be having some contractions." His reply was, "Joan, my mom advised me to call Dara, and they wanted to come in to get checked out." I was still in denial the whole way to Marshall. They strapped me into the monitor and had the ultrasound tech come in. She kind of had a panic look on her face and left the room quickly. In the meantime, I was still thinking everything was fine until a whole team of nurses rushed in, giving us information among the chaos. I remember having to ask the nurse, "Does this mean the baby's coming today?" And she replied with a simple, "Yes." That is when fear and panic came over me, and I just cried. Justin and the nurses were so good to comfort me, as all of these worried thoughts flooded my mind. Everything happened so fast, and about 30 minutes later, she was here. We had a baby girl. We couldn't believe it. It brought comfort to me as she came out crying. The team of nurses prepped her for her first plane ride to the NICU in Sioux Falls, which ended up being our new home for the next 2 months. The next day, I turned on my Pandora station as I took a shower, and the song Oceans by Hillsong United came on. This song has always been a favorite of mine, but as I listened, it now had a whole new meaning to me. The first verse says, "You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown, where my feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep, my faith will stand." Justin and I had just begun this journey of unknowns with our daughter. We felt so helpless as we saw Emery hooked up to the machines, but we knew it would be our faith that would get us through this. The next verse says, "And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you are mine." I remember praying as tears ran down my face, asking God to give me the strength to handle whatever would come our way. The song goes on to say, "Your grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you've never failed and you won't start now." This verse brought so much comfort to me as it reminded me that although we were afraid of the unknown, God has never failed us, and we were confident that he would help us through this. The final verse says, "Spirit lead me where my trust is without borders. Let me walk upon the waters wherever you would call me. Take me deeper than my feet can ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior." I was finally able to accept our new normal by putting all of our trust in God. I hung up Bible verses on the cabinets in our room so that I would have a constant reminder that God was going to help us through this. We grew on our faith, we trusted God, and we made it through. On May 11th, 3 days after Mother's Day, we were able to take our happy, healthy girl home. 4 months later, we found out we were expecting again. I was flooded with so many emotions. Of course, I was happy to have another sweet baby on the way, but I felt like I hardly knew what I was doing with Emery, and now we were about to have another child. Since I was considered high risk with this pregnancy, the thought of another NICU stay filled my mind, and how hard that would be to leave Justin and Emery at home. But again, I turned on the song Oceans and trusted in God's plan for our family. On April 10th, 2017, we welcomed our sweet Asher John here. We truly felt blessed that we were able to take our sweet, healthy boy home after only 3 days in the hospital. The last 14 months has been filled with trials and tribulations, but also so much joy. This Mother's Day, I'm blessed to be spending it with both my babies. I can't imagine life without them, and I'm so lucky to have such a wonderful, loving, and supportive husband to help raise them with me.
Sadie Solomon is our next speaker for Mother's Day. Sadie, along with her husband, Dean, have two boys, and can you do the line thing that you want to do? Brothers, you do to me. She taught me that we're all equal in God's eyes, and we're all deserving.
and that no matter what we face in life, there's eternal life waiting for us. I also want to teach my boys to have servants' hearts like my grandma Dora, and that being humbled and sacrificing for others isn't a sign of weakness. Rather, it's a life that resembles Jesus' life. And finally, as a woman of faith, I pray that my kids learn that God created all of us. We are all His children, unique and wonderful. And we should look through God's eyes when we look at others. See them as God sees them. That's what my mom has taught me. So despite trying to ignore and avoid Pastor Kendall's prodding to share with you today about what being a mom of faith means to me, I am grateful for this opportunity to share a bit about how my faith has influenced me by three great moms. And I consider myself fortunate not to have just these three influential women, but many others as well. The greatest gift we can give our children, I believe, is a life rooted in faith. Psalm 100, verse 5 says, "For the Lord is good. His unfailing love continues forever, and His faithfulness continues to each generation." And I pray that the faith shared with me by my grandmas and my mom will not end with me, but will continue to the next faithful generation. Happy Mother's Day.
Then we want to welcome Terry Bielitz to Grace Lutheran. Terry happens to be Dean's cousin, niece of Harold and Ruth Soul. So thank you so much for joining us here in Dawson.
Thank you. I'm sorry, Dean. I told her not to say that. Pastor, I have a question for you. Are you a praying man? A praying man. Do you pray?
Yes, I
pray. You might want to start now because you're the old girl up here. Well, happy Mother's Day. You know, it was fun to follow these two ladies. They are very good at some good messages for us. I'm going to be a little bit different today. It's hard for me to talk attached to something. I'm a walker, so. But I want to talk to you about kind of my life and what a mother means to me. And that not necessarily do moms have to give birth to be a mother. I've been a foster parent for 16 years, and May is National Foster Parent Month. So I want to share a little bit about that. I want to share about adoption, my real parents, and how life brought me where I am then. I've been through a lot of stuff, made a lot of more decisions. As a young person, I took off and kind of got into a lot of trouble. I chose a lot of things that were bad. I got into a lot of heavy drugs, into stealing, you name it. I was into it and did a lot of stuff. I ended up moving in and living with my Aunt Ruth and Harold. And that's where my first mother talk comes from, is the things that she taught me. And she did not have to give birth to me to be a mother to me. She taught me values and honesty and was a friend to me. She was honorable and did not, you know, mother, she never talked down to her children. I was thought it was pretty cool that, oh God, you know, was beforehand what's going on and how we can direct and guide our lives. Even the bulletin today, you know, so many things on it are things I want to talk about. And so it's just like He's always got us in our hands and guides us, I think, as moms or daughters, wherever we are. He takes us where we need to go. And Ruth really did that. She helped me go where I needed to go. And I never thought about it today until today on the way down here. Maybe Ruth helped direct me even to be a foster parent, because that never came into my mind. I remember growing up before that. And after I graduated from high school, left her home, I went off and still did a few stupid things. So even good moms can have bad children. We have our own personalities and kind of drive ourselves where we want to go. The whole time I was doing all that stupid stuff, there was always a small voice in my head that kept saying, "Terry, you're better than this. Terry, what are you doing?" And I ran from that voice for a long time. I didn't want to go where I knew what was leading me. But finally I did. I listened and I quit with the drugs and everything that was going on. I watched too many of my friends die from overdoses or using drugs that made them think they were Superman and they hurt themselves. And it was time for me to go back to a better life and use everything all those mothers had taught me. You know, it takes a village to raise our children. And I'd had more than I worked harder, who I loved dearly. I had a room time that other strong women in my life through our church and through friendships. As a foster parent, I've been the mother to over 60 children. I've been the mother to two boys who I'm so proud of. They're 28 years old and 26. I've been the grandmother to 11 children. I've been the stepmother to three children. And so there's been a lot of children coming through my home. I've had nieces live with me, just like my aunt Ruth and Carol did. I've helped raise other people's children. And I hope all of you guys realize how important moms are. We are more than just the dirty laundry and the dirty dishes and the food that's being cooked. Moms provide honor and value, and they should be someone who listens. I hear so many children, you know, kids always just love their grandmas so much. And there was a thing done, I don't remember where it was at, but they asked the kids, why do you love grandma so much? And almost all the kids said, because grandma actually listens to me. How many of us push our children away because we're too busy, we're making supper, we just got up from work, and we forget to take those 5 minutes when they come in the door to say, hey, what's up? And value them as equal humans. I think if we did, if we honored our children more, there would be less abuse and things going on in this world. Our lives are, you know, sometimes covered. I always saw myself as somebody covered in dirt from sin. If you take a clay ball and the bad choices we make just cover us with different sin, and everybody has that dirt on us somehow. None of us are perfect. We all make mistakes, no matter, just different levels of mistakes. But as you know, you do things and try and make your life better with other people, and follow that guidance that your mothers in your life have put out for you, and listen to what God wants for us in our lives. I think we can wash away that. Jesus died to get us perfectly clean, so that day will come when we go to heaven and we can be clean. I have a little joke, actually, I want to tell you about that. A mother had passed away and died and went to heaven up at the pearly gates, and Jesus was waiting there for her. And he said to her, to get into heaven, you have to spell a word. And she's like, oh, okay, what word do I have to spell? And she's like, he's like, spell sunshine. So she spells it, S-U-N-S-H-I-N-E. And she gets into heaven. And Jesus is like, hey, I have to go just quick. Will you watch the gate till I get back? And she's like, sure, I'll do that. So Jesus takes off, and she's standing there watching, and she sees her husband coming. She's just like, oh, yeah. And so he gets up to the gate, and she's like, spell arithmetic. And he just stands there. The power, the point is the power of a mother, the power of a wife. We have so much that we can give and put into people's lives around us. And so I think it's really important that we help our mothers and keep them as shiny as we can. And no matter how dirty we are outside, when you're out in that world and you see those sinners like I was and still am, I go to church because I do sin. But I was a bigger sinner back then. And people avoided me and shunned me because they were ashamed of me. Family were ashamed of who I was. And it's really hard to ask